Every night, I walk around the Gray Quarter and let them Grayskins know what I think of them. You! You a dark elf lover? Get out of our city, you filthy piece of trash! Wouldn't surprise me. They've done nothing to help in the fight for Skyrim's freedom. Those Thalmor elves, too. I bet they're working together. Maybe I should round up some men and take us a few prisoners to interrogate. They're parasites. They're living in our city under our protection. But what do they do for us? Nothing. I know the High King invited them here, but he didn't ask me or anyone else first. Maybe he should have. Don't like it? Too bad. This is our city. Ours! Don't think I can take you? 100 septims say I can punch you back where you came from. All right. Fists only. And none of that magic stuff either. Let's go. Come on. Let's see what you're made of.
You're just gonna stand there. Fight back.
That wasn't a fair swing.
Sons and daughters, the Stormcloaks. We drink to our youth, to the
days yeah, here.
For the age of oppression is now nearly done. We'll drive out the empire from this land.
Good to see you again, friend.
With our blood and our steel, we will take back our. This is an ode to Skyrim's.
This here's Candlehearth Hall. Great rooms upstairs, and there's a bed for rent on the ground floor. Did you see the candle above the fire upstairs? It was lit 163 years ago, back when this building was the home of a grand warrior named Vundheim. When word came that he'd fallen, his son Durok lit the candle in his honor. Nobody knows why it still burns.
All hail to Ulfric. You are the High King. In your great honor.
Enjoy your stay, and don't break nothing.
We're the children.
Fur coming out of your ears.
There's you one of those Skyrim for the Nords types? And you're right, at least as far as I'm concerned. Don't let Ulfric or some of these other short-sighted Nords bother you. Most of us are happy to welcome newcomers. Whenever a group of marauders attack a Nord village, Ulfric is the first to sound the horn and send the men. But a group of Dark Elf refugees gets ambushed, a group of Argonians or a Khajiit caravan, no troops, no investigation, nothing. There's a group of cutthroats out there right now that Ulfric doesn't lift a finger to bring to justice. As long as they don't threaten Nord land. That's a brave offer. I'd be happy to throw in my coin behind that. You deal with them. I'll make sure you get paid. Maybe this old soldier will throw in some lessons as well. I killed a lot of high elves in the Great War, and I didn't die. I guess that makes me a war hero. The Great War. There was nothing great about it. Thousands died on both sides. And where did it get us? Did we really save the Empire? Or did we just plant the seeds for Ulfric's uprising? And another war. Help the Dark Elves? Oh, you must have heard me talking to Malfir. The Dark Elves live in a run-down slum called the Grey Quarter. Ulfric's content to keep it that way. I guess they think I can open Ulfric's eyes to their plight, and get him to lift a finger on their behalf. I'm trying, but Ulfric is set in his ways. For him, there's two kinds of people in this world. Nords, and the folk beneath them. Show those marauders what Windhelm justice tastes like.
Ulfric won't give us a straight answer.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
Don't be so sure of that. We've intercepted couriers from Solst.
I'm not much of a strategist, but Lord Ulfric listens to my counsel all the same.
And what would you have me do?
Grew up here. Cold as Atmora, that just grows the beard sticker. Lot of history in these walls. We're trying to make some more. It's a lucky time to be alive.
How long are you going to wait?
For Ulfric? Well, nothing official. Known him for years. He seems to value my thoughts, and I'm grateful for that. I don't really have a mind for war, and I think he likes having an untrained opinion from time to time. Travel safely. It's dangerous out here.
I still say you should take them all out like you did dead King Torrig.
Torrig was merely a message. Yes? Make it quick. I'm a busy man. Not entirely true. Though not entirely false, either. Any Nord can learn the way of the voice by studying with the Greybeards, given enough ambition and dedication. By shouting Torrig to the ground, proved he had neither. However, it was my sword piercing his heart that killed him. Dalius has camps in the Pale, entertaining thoughts of battle. The Empire still underestimates the force of our cause. It will be their undoing. Soon enough, we will march on Solitude, and on that day the heroes of Sovngarde will march with us. And the Empire will fall to its knees in fear. We're fighting because we're done bleeding for an Empire that won't bleed for us. Untold numbers of Nords died defending the Empire against the Dominion. And for what? Skyrim being sold to the Thalmor so the Emperor could keep his throne. We're fighting because our own Jarls, once strong, wise men, have become fearful and blind to the people suffering. We're fighting because Skyrim needs heroes, and there's no one else but us. The Empire thinks it holds Valkyrie from us, but the souls of Skyrim's bravest are buried there and will fill our hearts and strengthen our blades. I killed Torrig to prove our wretched condition. How is the High King supposed to be the defender of Skyrim, if he can't even defend himself? Indeed, Elisif has become Jarl of Solitude. Historically and conveniently home of the High King, backed by Imperial interests. But the Moot has not yet met to name her High Queen, and they won't. Not as long as I have any say in it. I challenged him in the traditional way, and he accepted. There were many witnesses. No murder was committed. True, he didn't stand a chance against me. But that was precisely the point. He was a puppet king of the Empire, not a High King of Skyrim. His father before him, perhaps, but not Torric. He was too privileged and too foolish. More interested in entertaining his queen than ruling his country. There hasn't been a true High King in Skyrim for generations. For too long, he's been hand-picked by the Emperor and given emphatic nods by milk-drinking jarls addicted to Imperial coin. It's time we had a real High King, one of our own making. My father, the Great Bear of Eastmarch, died during my imprisonment after the Markarth incident. I, his only son, forced to deliver his eulogy via letter I had smuggled out of prison, such as the love of Titus Mead for his subjects. When finally set free, I returned to Windhelm and was greeted by a city in mourning, at one with my own grief and anger, clamoring in angry voices, calling out for justice, for war. They sat me on the throne of Ysgrimor. The throne of my father. I only hope I can prove worthy of that honor. Is that so? I've been wondering when he'd come around. Oh, what's this? You're quite brave to carry such a message. It's a pity you've chosen the wrong side. You can return this axe to the man who sent it, and tell him he should prepare to entertain visitors. I expect a great deal of excitement in the city of Whiterun in the near future. I have shown the people that when our jarls drink the Empire's milk, it makes us weak. I must now show them the path that will lead us back to our strength. There is no progress without sacrifice, no wheat without threshing the chaff. The Empire and the Jarls who back them must be swept away. The people demand it. I demand it. Sooner than you think.
We're ready when you are.
Things hinge on Whiterun. If we can take the city without bloodshed...
You are taking us somewhere warm, I trust.
The people are
really? Gisargo was having such fun. Ah, well, back to the college then.
And let them die with their false kings.
We've been soldiers a long time.
Across the river to the northeast lies Ingolvaro. Steer clear of that foul place.
You should unload some of that unwanted gear. Head over to Sadri's used wares and talk to the end.
You're a war hero, Runwolf. Ulfric will listen to you. You've seen how we live. Cramped alleys, run-down buildings, few guard patrols. Even the name Grey Quarter is an insult. That's all I ask. With your help, we have a chance to make a better life for ourselves. I thought the Grey Quarter would be a haven for my kind. I was wrong.
Watch the skies, traveler.
lost, friend.
Never should have come.
Yeah. Split your belly like an old woman.
Sure. May I just say it's a pleasure to have
Restoration
you.
Restoration is a perfectly valid school of magic.
All right,
don't
then.
Let anyone tell you.
All
right, then.
Slip to our grasp. Oh, what we might have learned.
If there's ever anywhere I can see, please let me know.
Search materials constantly disappearing.
There we go, done with
the everyone without disaster.
That would clear up us.
The sands are cold. But Khajiit feels warmness from your presence. Then lead on, friend.
Perhaps we can go another few decades without a disaster. That would be nice.
me, Ed. Don't fancy those clunky two-handed weapons. If you're here for sightseeing, well, thieves. Can I help you?
How come you're in Winterhold? My pa says people like you are the reason no one lives here. My pa says elves are bad and not to trust them.
Talos guide you. Keep your eyes open.
Ours is the only family left that truly cares about us.
Be a lot warmer and a lot happier with a belly full of meat.
Greetings, brother. You look weary. I have something to help you relax, if you're interested. The finest skooma, the sweetest moon sugar, at a fair price, of course. Ah, a snitch, huh? Can't have you running to any guards now, can I? Never should have come here! Oh!
stay alert. Never know when those Stormcloak dogs might charge.
Auxiliary.
Keep an eye out for trouble. It's only a matter of time.
Hand over your valuables, or I'll gut you like a fish. Nice try, but you don't scare me. I'm not gonna ask again. Don't you walk away from me! Until next time. Boosh!
You are taking us somewhere warm, right? Really? Gisargo was having such fun. Ah, well. Back to the college, then.
Thank you. There are few places where one can pursue might and power without fear of persecution.
Good to see Skyrim still has such fine. Give an old man hope. I like it or not, you are a shining example. Very good. I'm sure the Jarl will be quite pleased. Pleased enough to justify the significant amount of gold offered to the college to rectify the problem. I think it only fitting that the Archmage personally receive a large portion of the reward. Well done. Mm-hmm.